exactly as planned.
Just as planned, always as planned. Nahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahahah of chaos, there is also opportunity. Santi's Edu. Hope in reality is the worst of all evils because it prolongs the torments of man. Friedrich Nietzsche. I accept chaos, I'm not sure whether it accepts me. Bob Dylan. Oh fortune, like the moon you are changeable, ever waxing and waning. Hateful life, first oppresses, and then soothes as fancy takes it. Poverty and power, it melts them like ice. Fate, monstrous and empty, you whirling wheel, you are malevolent. Well-being is in vain and always fades to nothing. O Fortuna, from the Carmina Burana. I pretty much try to stay in a constant state of confusion just because of the expression it leaves on my face. Johnny Depp. Tsinj thinking to himself, hum, I wonder what plans I would foil again. Introduction. Tsinj, pronounced Tsinj, also known as Jar, Che the Deceiver, Tsintsin, Nyarlathotep, the Troll Master, Cheens, the Raven God, the Trickster, the Lord of Nerds, B, Emperor Lollicoaster, International Jury, the Indecisive Mollusk, Lord Talky Crotch, Hyperdimensional Rick Sanchez, and 9986 other names is the Chaos God of Change, Curiosity, Lies, Ambition, Mutation, Pure Chaos, Machiavelli, Politics, Manipulation, Trolling, the Internet, Progress, Knowledge, Magic, Chess, Lawyers, and despite being the closest chaos god who matches the profile of a high-functioning psychopath Hope, despite there being a contender for God of Hope. In Warhammer Fantasy he already existed before the world like the other chaos gods, and the old ones actively tried to prevent demons from ever successfully invading the world by creating the different races of the game in an attempt to find something that could cheese demons in. Every battle until the very warp gates that the old ones used to come to the planet in the first place collapsed, forming miniature eyes of terror at the poles of the world just as planned. He is said to have a fetish for ravens amongst the Norse tribes and condors amongst Kilgan nomads. There's no real picture for Tsinj since the weird bastard always changes his appearance every time he sits for his yearbook photo. Some of the more memorable appearances have been an opaline serpent constantly slithering in place. A no-neck blue greater demon with a skin pocked with faces that each repeat what the main head just said with different emphasis or tone. A rainbow-hued cloud of mist that speaks by casting echoes off nearby structures without making the original sound. A featureless green-skinned human in an archaic gray suit with the words "no picture available" suspended in the air where his face would be. And perhaps the most prominent, a giant imp with two penises growing out of its head. No, seriously. Unless, he could be Slan. Urgle burgle. Strangely, Tsinj was often attributed to Hope in the two settings, despite there being chaos gods of order in fantasy, and in 40k the god emperor of mankind serving as the god of hope in his career even if he never wanted to be worshipped as such. To be fair, there is a difference between hope and order. The chaos gods embody traits that can be directed for good or evil. How can hope be evil? To invoke Godwin's law. Hitler hoping his genocide plans would succeed was evil, or as in Pandora's box where hope prolongs suffering. It is entirely possible that what Games Workshop incorrectly called hope is more accurately called selfish ambition, the sort that would drive people to commit Machiavellian backstabbing. Because in the grim darkness of the 41st millennium, actual selfless hope is pretty much a rotting corpse. He is typically the second strongest of the chaos gods, however he has advantage over Khorne when it comes to IQ, manipulation and leadership. In canon Chaos God vs Chaos God stories he has the largest number of victories and fewest number of defeats. He rarely does things directly and prefers to trick one of the chaos gods or their servants into fighting with one another to the point that one can assume any time a chaos god goes to war with another one, he is probably behind it. He got Skarbrand, the then mightiest bloodthirster, to attack his master. Skarbrand hit with all his strength but only put a chink in Khorne's armor, and Khorne got unbelievably, incomprehensibly, all-consumingly pissed and grabbed Skarbrand and threw him so hard that he went sailing in the sky for days before finally crashing into the ground so hard that his wings broke. And whenever Tsinj gets caught into these antics, most especially by an enraged Khorne, he could simply recite the rules. Yes, chaos have strange rules, and testify to the circumstances proving that he wasn't responsible. If everyone including the emperor and the chaos gods want to find him guilty for cheating, then he will just twist it back to them because he wasn't violating the rules set by the highest authorities. In the tabletop, the mods, in other words, Tsinj is a cosmic attorney. Except that millions of his followers will likely be slaughtered and his faith likely has a new enemy, Bitsenge. Like every chaos god, is beyond our petty definition of victory and defeat. Which makes the above paragraph idiotically inaccurate, like most of our concepts of reality when the warp gets involved. Once Tsinch was the strongest of all the chaos gods and basically made the warp his bitch. In 40k this was actually tied to a real world time period now known as a dark age of technology, the golden age of prosperity, hope, ambition, and progress, when humanity and Elder, who dominated the galaxy, defeated the diseases and poverty with their sophisticated science and sorcery and waged their wars through emotionless constructs and robots. No wonder Tsinch was supercharged by these events and the other two gods were at their lowest of the lows. Unfortunately for him, he didn't plan on the other two chaos gods agreeing to team up against him and was shattered into countless fragments. It was his crystal staff in the old lore. Unlike a certain other god, he was able to put himself back together again, but he's still missing several pieces of himself. In fantasy those pieces went on to become the first magic, and in 40k they caused a massive burst of powerful Sickers being born. Which combined with a robot rebellion humans experienced and pleasure cult Elder went into brought the downfall of both civilizations, effectively ending their golden ages. Although, given the nature of gods, it's possible that the cause-consequence chain was the other way around, with a war in the warp being the representation of two great prosperous empires falling from their grace. The blue scribes are tasked with recollecting these fragments. Tsinch also claims the realm of Shaman and the Age of Sigma. The Slan managed to create the Halosphere as a passageway to Tsinch's lair. If Tsinch had a voice actor, Tsinch would need different ones all the time. A good candidate is Aiden Pettibeelish Gillen, the first depiction of Tsinch in Warhammer art. Tsinch has a fetish for birds, Fethapornahoy. Oddly, this is one of the rare few visibly female lords of change, probably because birds don't usually have tits. Ever heard of a blue tit, ya fuck noob? Why settle for a blue tit when you can have a great tit? Wait a minute, they're fucking birds. Why do they need boobs, fanservice? Because chaos. And Tsinch wants a harem in all likelihood. Elf Elder Gods, in 40k. He was seemingly the only chaos god who didn't try to intervene when Slaanesh went on his It's Just Born raping and killing spree as far as we know. But Tsinch seldom works directly, so there's no way to tell for sure. In Warhammer Fantasy, Ashuran is something of the roadrunner to his wily coyote. While Tsinch's flawless and infinitely intricate plans of dickery seem to culminate with the warp enveloping the world, something always goes wrong at the last minute, and usually the High Elves or an ally of the High Elves are at the center of it. That's because Ashuran also has a plan, one he actually shares with mortal High Elves who take a vow of silence and become his monks. Ashuran's plan is not flawless, however, and culminates in one giant last battle with a 50% chance of success or fail on his behalf between good order and evil destruction. The outcome of that battle will decide if the Chaos Gods win or lose once and for all. Apparently, dragons will go extinct either way though. It turns out that his plan didn't work out. Tsinch also has direct relations with Moray Hegg, who is a goddess of prophecy who can actively change fate at her will. Moray Hegg is a true neutral kind of being who fucks with everyone's plans in ways that end up with them indebted to her one way or another. Usually because she manipulates things in a way to force you to come to her to undo the change she already made. You don't know she did this in the first place and make a third result, which someone else probably asked for due to a change someone else made, and, well, let's just summarize it as everyone's plans are all going according to plan. Just as planned. Tsinch will always be three steps ahead of you. He outdicks Eldred, the Laughing God, both God Emperors, and the Deceiver hands down. Just an example, he tricked Slaanesh into provoking Khorne, a fight he promptly lost. Why did he do it? He did it for fun. Just don't mention Creed around him. In Warhammer Fantasy, he's notable for never really doing much of anything really except trapping Sigma for years in the Wind of Heaven until Vortex on Ulthven is destroyed in the wind. Under Sigma's direction, enters the body of Emperor Colfrance after his death. His champions either have magical powers or limited ability to see and manipulate the future. Some just follow more charismatic champions of other chaos gods into battle, although when that champion inevitably falls, Tsinch is almost always survived to mutate another day. The setting's China equivalent, Cathay, has wizards actively stealing Tsinch's magic and using its effects to affect the world with greater power than normal magic can. They do this entirely without worshipping him or suffering chaos mutations or taint according to the fluff. They do worship Tsinch. They just know him by another name and don't know his true nature. This is most likely a reference to Daoism and Yijing, the Book of Change. Clearly Tsinch mostly just focuses on 40k while the other three chaos gods play two tables at once, or maybe Tsinch is lulling the Cathayans into a false sense of security. The funny thing is, Tsinch's plots will never come to true fruition. They just go on and on, forever and ever, twisted and tangled for the sheer joy of it, with no end goal or even a purpose behind them. Tsinch is a god of chaos, and a plan satisfied, tied up, finished, is a plan that has left his purview. There is no victory, no defeat, no end. Ends are stagnation, the opposite of all he represents. There will only be the endless clatter of dice in the mad, cruel games the gods play with the fates and souls of men. Rolled without end, amen. In this sense, Tsinch truly is the chaos god of hope, because he will never allow chaos to defeat the mortal plane if he can, at least, not if it doesn't lead to further changes. While most everyone else plays to win, Tsinch plays for fun, for as long as he can. In older fluff, Tsinch was also the chaos god of magic and intellect, so if anyone wanted Tsinch to win, they just had to make a clever plan that would further Tsinch's goals and pull it off. Increase the amount of magic in the world or become a wizard, so technically every time a storm of magic happens would be a victory for Tsinch, though GW has downplayed that aspect of him. Possibly the god of I meant to do that. Followers. Tsinch's followers tend to be librarians, wizards, sorcerers, nerds, sickers, magical beings, unstable mutants, and red-nosed misfits, but instead of Nurgles, I love you just for who you are. Tsinch encourages his followers to revel in what makes them dweeb outcasts and go even further, constantly finding new ways to push limits and try things out just because they can. It's not enough that you've made this former guardsman loyal, harder and better, faster and stronger, you could also fit another three arms on the guy, and if you added a head on his pelvis he would never be surprised, and he can't talk anymore, so why not replace his larynx with a flame sack? Whereas other chaos gods accidentally pour too much love into their subjects' slanish quite literally, Tsinch does it on purpose because he actually knows what he's doing when he does so. Tsinch demons are pink horrors, ever-shifting gleeful balls of psychic rape. Really powerful ones are heralds of Tsinch. Courtesy of 6th edition 40k, these guys are now Brotherhood of Sorcerers, and a blob of 16 or more horrors can cast 3 spells per turn, and since they are demons of Tsinch they test on LD10. Unfortunately, all the powers they have are fun. 8th edition fantasy sees them as a blob of level 1 wizards who can't miscast, which are fun due to the randomness of them but aren't really competitive. The best known of these is a being called a changeling, who has the ability to transform into any being it wants, usually for the purposes of wreaking havoc behind enemy lines, although it has also been known to do so for pulling pranks as well. Like planting Nurglings on the skull throne just as Khorne is about to sit down, or cutting Slaanesh's hair while she sleeps. Apparently it's changed its form so many times it doesn't even remember what it originally used to look like. Blue horrors: when you kill a pink horror, it splits into two tiny, manic depressive blue horrors. In 40k it just means your pink horrors hit back at S2 every time you kill one in close combat, which is kind of useless. Why are your horrors in close combat anyway? The fantasy version of them are summonables that enter onto the field when the magic lore of Tsinch sees a spell casted, very well since your pink horrors cannot miscast. Throwing a fuckload of dice into a spell to produce more blue horrors is nifty. They're pretty weak though anyway, which is what keeps full of Tsinch armies from really being viable. A particularly notable pair of blue horrors are Petarix and Zirat, also known as the Blue Scribes. Tsinch sent them out to catalog every single magic spell in reality, knowing that they weren't smart enough to know how easily abused the power of said spells might be. Finally fixed in Age of Sigmar, as they're now just weaker pink horrors that you place to when a pink horror dies. Brimstone horrors, also known as yellow horrors, recently added in Age of Sigmar and 40k, oddly never mentioned until now since 3 is a running theme for Tsinch. When a blue horror dies they turn into a pair of angry little fire demons. Flamers like horrors but less limb-wise and way more mouths to breathe fire with. Also, this fire is S4 AP4. If you inflict wounds on a unit they have to take a toughness test, and if they fail they suffer D3 wounds with no saves allowed. On the other hand, if they pass the toughness test they get Feel No Pain 6, which can stack if they keep passing. They're the main demon ranged option in Warhammer Fantasy, although they're pretty close range. Best used to shotgun an enemy right in the flank while it's engaged with something from one of the other chaos gods in melee. Just as planned, right there in the crunch. Screamers of Tsinch: that Tsinchian notion of cavalry, levitating manta rays with buzzsaw fins, also melt a teeth for some reason. In fantasy they function as chaff by harassing units and weakening them, with great luck killing something important like a mage or forcing them to devote a turn killing them and thus leaving that unit open to whatever other demons you brought. Burning chariots of siege, one-man vehicles for heralds of siege, or exalted flamers, which are like flamers but exalted. In 40k this is where the aptitude siege flame attack went after flamers got a buff, but it's assault d3 for optimal fun, and it also has a RS5 up 3 torrent attack. These both follow the same warp flame rules as flamers do, but they also won't be leaving so many survivors, so it's not as big a deal. Fantasy sees them as the surprise butt 6 machine, once again tearing through an enemy that's engaged with something else. Like Tsinch's architectural styles though, it's a glass cannon that will break if damn near anything short of an anemic Bretonian peasant orphan with a cold attacks it. Lords of Change, huge bird-like sorcerers that look like a werewolf's in-between state, only it's a werevulture snake velociraptor thing. They have the power to predict the future at any given time, so they're almost invincible, unless Tsinch wants them to die. Which, going by all the times Tsinchian Chaos Demon and Thousand Suns armies lose, happens surprisingly often. They're the best non-named spellcaster available to demons in fantasy. Chief among their number is Tsinch's right-hand demon Keris Fachova, who was gifted the ability to know everything that will ever happen along with the second head. It's said that he knows the answers to all questions, but if you ask him, both heads give contradicting answers, with no way of knowing which head is telling the truth. Just don't ask him his name. Then again, there's nothing saying it's the same one lying every time. Tsinch's Chaos Marines come with an Egyptian motif, and plenty of Sickers and Sorcerers. Aside from that, Tsinchian Marines are usually warband leaders, their advisors or prominent ambitious champions wishing to become one. Many of them hold their dedication to the Architect in secret, if only to keep their advantage of God's favor over other Marines. Ambition after all is a big deal for them. Fully Tsinchian warbands do exist, but they are usually comprised of complete madmen who hear voices, see future, hear all the lies in the world simultaneously, can shapeshift or mutate at will, or have some other mind-blowing, sometimes literally, gifts from the Architect. It helps that Tsinch is likely based on the ancient Egyptian god Thoth. Tsinch's Viking followers are usually the outcasts and elders of the tribes of the Norsemen rather than being a united group. They like to rock the evil wizard look with hooded cloaks and sacrificial daggers to complement their tentacles and three faces on one head. He is also worshipped by the Cathayans as their state religion. Facts: Slimabo is the only person that Tsinch cannot control. That and Creed, that sneaky fucker, who is currently holding a gun to my- The name Tsinch was originally going to be Thence of Change, which is a six-letter anagram of Tsinch. The TZ was later added and the name reworked at the suggestion of John Blanche returning from holiday in Tanzania, where he saw a blue-feathered bird performing tricks at the request of a tribal priest named Tuz Tuz. Tsinch is likely inspired by the ancient Egyptian god Thoth. Thoth was the bird-headed god of writing, science and magic. Remember what Tsinch's greater demons look like? A little known fact: Tsinch is anonymous. Tsinch was responsible for the Great Depression and the 2008 financial crisis. Also, the first Gulf War, that was him too. Tsinch does it for the lulz. You know when your first puppy died? Tsinch did that too. Tsinch, much like Slimabo, knows and sees everything. Thusly, he sees you masturbate and knows what fantasies you're having. And he laughs at you again, much like Slimabo. Corn is Tsinch's favorite victim for hijinks because Corn is very easy to string along. Slaanesh is Tsinch's second favorite victim for his hijinks, because Slaanesh's desire for a new high makes him Hurric very easy to string along. Starscream is a servant of Tsinch. He has got a huge amount of ambition. Too bad that Tsinch won't let him succeed until he actually forms a plan instead of just saying I am the new leader if Megatron so much as sneezes. Tsinch is the god of hope among other things, yet he is a lot less friendly than the god of despair. Probably because most every being in the universe has had their fair share of despair and has learned to cope with it, while hope tends to show up just before you get ground into the dirt again. When the despair god comes knocking, you open a bottle and sigh. When the hope god shows up, you immediately wonder how you're going to get raped this time. Tsinch is only ever truly lost to two beings: Creed and a little kitten wearing a silver banana armor. Tsinch is a very murky god due to the fact he could set in motion a string of events that could lead to a lasgun in the back of the head when you aren't looking. Tsinch is the only contestant to ever be banned from entering Deal or No Deal after winning 1,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000, the other Chaos Gods. Among the three, Korn asked Sinch how he made Nurgle's plague of father disappear and reappear beside Slaanesh before their very eyes. Which Sinch refused to tell and responded with, "A good magician never reveals his tricks," which caused Korn to burn with unfathomable rage. To this day, Korn still loathes magic and anyone who uses them, which became evident when the World Eaters killed all their sickers when they defected to Chaos. Like always, Tsinch just said just as planned. Tsinch is slightly pissed over the fact how his only representation in Dao are the Pink Horror Demons and the Chaos Sorcerer, unlike Korn who gets berserkers. Chaos Marines chant skulls for the Skull Throne on attack and how he got an epic unit. The Bloodthirster and the fact that he has two Chaos Lords dedicated to him and the fact that his Legion shows up in Winter Assault as one of the primary opponents. Korn then goes on to get Bloodletters, Bloodcrushers, the Chaos Lord, who is the best damn commander in the game, though the Warbus has funnier dialogue in Dao AI, while in contrast, he's stuck with the Sorcerer and his Marines aren't even rubrics. Still, better than Slaanesh, who only ever got the Emperor's Children default color scheme throughout the entire series. But now Slaanesh is getting Noise Marines in Retribution, which are sorta like SM Plasma Cannon Devastators. Altsinch gets earmarks for certain units, which turns every one of them into tank infantry raping death machines, especially the generic Marines. However, in Dao AI, Tsinch is still reveling in the fact how he got Scott McNeil to voice the generic Chaos Sorcerers again. However, the Sorcerer's voice then became more soft, monotonous and unenthusiastic, which greatly angered Tsinch. Tsinch appears to be GW's least favorite of the Chaos Gods, his units tend to be the worst out of the four Chaos Gods, his stuff gets the least amount of attention, and the least amount of fluff written for him. Hell, there's often cases where despite magic psychic powers being his specialty, Nurgle and or Slaanesh give a better selection than he does. Except for Age of Sigmar, where he's really good. Some people play chess with reality and manipulate events and people like chess pieces. Others play pool billiards with it, moving things along like a cue ball and cue stick. Others play poker with the universe, bluffing and cajoling things to receive favorable outcomes. Others play roulette with the cosmos, making all the little movements needed for that lucky roll. But Tsinch does it all at once in the nightmarish game of Paradox Billiards Vostroy in Roulette 4th Dimensional Hypercube Chess Strip Poker. Or PBVRFDHCSP, a game that only a true master of dickery and the ability to perceive the past, future, and present can really play without looking like a massive tool. Every Saturday night, Tsinch gets together with the Deceiver, Segarach, and the Emperor for a rousing game of Paradox Billiards Vostroy in Roulette 4th Dimensional Hypercube Chess Strip Poker. The sheer amount of dickery and just as planned that goes on during these games is so vast that if you were to watch one of these games, your head would explode into a shower of Necrons, Demons, Elder, and Space Marines. Even Korn is afraid to watch one of these games for fear of his head's unexplodedness. Nobody ever wins though, mainly because the Emperor take too long on his turns. Creed was banned from these tournaments after infiltrating queens into the games and somehow rigging the roulette tables beforehand one too many times. Tsinch's favorite characters in Mortal Kombat are Quan Chi, Shinnok and Shang Tsung. Though Tsinch favors Quan Chi more than the other two due to him being arguably the most manipulative bastard in all of Mortal Kombat. Hell, he is mostly responsible for almost all the events that happened. In fact, Quan Chi is considered the most untrustworthy character in all of Mortal Kombat considering that he has chronic backstabbing disorder, constantly lies and never fulfills his promises. Tsinch's favorite Black Library novel is A Thousand Suns. This is mostly because he relishes over the fact that he is such a magnificent bastard for all the things he did in said novel. Tsinch created CS Multilaser to specifically troll Korn's fluff. Tsinch has planned everything you do, even this. Who knows what this article is distracting you from? Tsinch does because he's why you're here. Whoa, where do you think you're going? You're leaving, eh? Just as planned. Tsinch didn't write this article, but he set in motion every single event that contributed to it. Yes, even this specific author's decision to write this paragraph. The one place Tsinch is afraid to go is the Well of Eternity. He believes that it is the beginning and end of the universe. He was wrong. It is where Slimabo lives. To find out what was in there, he sent an expedition to the Lords of Change and Horrors, but they never came back out. Finally, he just grabbed Keris Fachova, his vizier, and threw him in. Due to lots and lots of just as planned, Fachova survived but was horribly disfigured. Mabo slapped himself for letting that one get away and forced himself to keep doing push-ups until a planet the size of Jupiter was split in half for self-discipline. The Warcraft and Starcraft franchises' existence are both Steinch's doing. He is the one that caused GW to turn down Blizzard's initial offer to make an RTS game. When Fatueva was interrogated about why Steinch did that, the lying hair dodged the question and the truth-telling one said that there was no reason. Or did it? Created Facebook, regretted it instantly but managed to troll the whole planet by making them buy Oculus Rift. No real logic just to fuck up Oculus's release schedule. It worked just as planned. Contrary to what many would assume, Steinch is terrible at RTS games because he can never focus on one goal for a long enough period of time to focus on winning. Or at least that's the reason he claims why he lost at Supreme Commander to an illiterate orc that did nothing but hit random keys the entire game. Steinch claims that Snowflame was his doing, arguing who else could be insane enough to create such a character. Slaanesh claims that Steinch is lying and that Snowflame is his or its doing, but Steinch points out that Slaanesh is also a liar, meaning that nobody knows who is lying. Steinch's realm is guarded by a labyrinth that can only be passed by the mad. It was only defeated once, by a little girl with a small black dog, and even Steinch doesn't know how because the guardians refuse to discuss it. This is canon. Steinch invented Scrappy-Doo because he was bored. Steinch was the first being to create the Death Note. Possibly the one who made the idea of it all and gifted this to the Shinigami themselves. Since Steinch achieves his goals by having his many plans constantly foil each other and benefiting from the fallout of said foiled plans, this makes him one of the few beings who achieves just as planned as a direct consequence of not as planned. Depending on how you think about it, this means Steinch could technically be considered a god of both. If the Deceiver and Steinch battle and the Deceiver wins, Steinch actually wins in disguise. And vice versa. And this effect is cumulative. Therefore an unending cycle of win or don't win is created. There are currently over 9,000 such cycles in existence. Steinch has a pet cat that is both alive and dead. Steinch can be defeated with the following train of logic. You so Steinch, you are a god of chaos? Steinch yes. You so you would say that you are completely unpredictable? Steinch yes. You so that means it is predictable that you will be unpredictable? Steinch. Steinch is the reason the internet's hyperlinks are blue. Steinch coined the phrase you activated my trap card. Steinch created the bug that causes Gandhi to go nuclear in civilization. Greedo shooting first was Steinch doing. Steinch's favorite Gundam character is Char Aznable. The sheer amount of just as planned that the Red Comet uses put a grin on his face for a brief moment. If you haven't already check out my Redbubble portfolio, you might just find something you like.
This is not okay. This needs to stop now. This is cancer. This is so much cancer that I can feel the tumors growing on my back. And it's weighing down heavy on me, and it's not okay. Can you help a nigga out and just stop this? Please?